Yes, go ahead.
Yeah. Well, good morning, everyone. I'm sorry I can't be visible, but that's okay. I want to thank the organizers of the event, Rob, Henrik, and Gracia, and all the other volunteers for having me on this important day. I want to encourage everybody who is listening to donate to this important cause and to follow the hashtag ELTD for Puerto Rico. My presentation is called Breaking the Cycle of Adversity Through Education. And the reason why I chose to pick this topic is both personal and professional. It's a very personal topic for me because I had the unfortunate experience of living through a disaster zone, adversity. And that was during a civil war. I lived, part of my childhood was during a civil war, which lasted until I was 10 years old. And that period was followed by a period of migration away from the home that I had known, and followed by poverty and homelessness. So I've experienced the adversity in a very personal way. And what is important to know about what's happening in Puerto Rico right now, it is this, in addition to all the adversity that it creates for everyone, is that it particularly affects young people. People who should be in school right now. And the reason it's so important is that when something like this happens, you experience a loss of educational opportunities. Think of the lost intellectual potential, the power to solve local and global problems. And we all know that there are enormous problems facing the planet that the next generation is going to inherit in order to survive. So if this next generation doesn't have the tools and the education required to solve these problems, we're in trouble. So that's why this topic is so important to me. Despite the adversity that I experienced, I was fortunate enough to encounter one teacher who made a huge difference in my life. And I still remember her. She saw through the external signs that I displayed. I did not want to talk about my condition, but she saw through those signs and she helped me overcome the obstacles I was facing in my life. And so much later in life, I decided to pursue a doctoral degree in social foundations of education. And I selected the theme of resilience as the topic for my dissertation. So my research involved interviewing people who had all experienced extreme forms of diversity and had nevertheless found success through education. And so resilience was the main pathway for them to have overcome the adversity. And so, in fact, we define resilience as the ability to bounce back from adversity. And so I interviewed these people, and one of the key questions I wanted to address in the study was whether resilience was an innate trait of individuals, which is something that some people believed at the time, Or could it be acquired? And if so, what factors contribute to resilience? So the key findings that I found were that resilience can be acquired, and it can be acquired provided certain factors are in place, both internal factors and external factors. I also found that resilience is a process and not a measurable trait of individuals, and that the social and cultural context is crucial to enabling or disabling resilience. And finally, that policymakers have a very important role in either making or breaking resilience. So why is this all relevant to English language teachers like you? Well, as English language teachers, we often work with students who are vulnerable. In the US and Canada, for example, there's a disproportionate number of English language students, learners, who live in poverty, who face linguistic and cultural adjustments in a new environment, who may have had interrupted formal education. And this type of adversity can be extremely difficult to overcome. But the good news is that teachers like you can play a critical role in promoting resilience among your students. So how can you do that? Well, first of all, by noticing them, by paying attention, by acknowledging them and taking interest in their personal lives, by encouraging them and also by advocating for them among your colleagues. And also by holding high expectations of them. Just because students experience adversity doesn't mean that they don't have potential. And so the higher expectations you can hold for them, and the higher level of achievement they will achieve. But these high expectations need to be matched with high levels of support. So helping students receive high levels of support is equally important to having high expectations. And so creating support systems, listening, helping with lessons, representing them in your school or your institution, are all strategies that can foster resilience among students who experience adversity. And so as teachers, we are one of the most critical components of a successful journey out of adversity. We hold power, and if used in the service of the most vulnerable students, this power can turn their world around. So you can have a very positive influence in the lives of your students, no matter what their circumstances. Also, I would say, please take care of yourself, because as the saying goes, you can't give from an empty cup. So you, as Christine said before, taking care of yourself is one of the most important things you can do. You cannot, if you feel depleted, you're not in a position to help others. So as teachers, you really need to foster your own resilience. So I'm going to conclude here by wishing our friends in Puerto Rico and in all parts of the world that are experiencing disaster, I wish them strength and courage. I will end with a quote by L.R. Nost, K-N-O-S-T. She's an author, she's a feminist, and she's a social justice activist, speaking up for children. And I feel that this quote is very relevant to the current situation. She said, "Do not be dismayed by the brokenness of the world. All things break and all things can be mended. The broken world waits in darkness for the light that is you. And I find that quote very inspirational, particularly on days when we feel a little discouraged by and overwhelmed by the situation. You never doubt that you can make a difference. Thank you again to the organizers, and please consider donating for this worthy cause. Go to the website, follow the hashtag ELTDay for Puerto Rico. I wish you a wonderful day, and thanks again for having me.